Hello guys, welcome to a new video where I show all the steps to build a complete backend with Spring Boot. This video is the second part of the one dedicated to the test, to the integration test. In the previous one, I've handled the main dependencies of JUnit 5, Mockito and Spring Test. And now I will show how to write tests for controllers and repositories against a database. Take a seat, click on subscribe and let's go. The difference between testing services and testing controllers is that when testing a service, I must call directly the method I want to test. But for the controllers, I must call the URL with arguments, dynamic parameters, payloads, or files. This time, Mockito is not enough. I must use the Spring Boot test annotation. Prepare the web context and the dependency injection context. This object belongs to the web context of a Spring test to perform HTTP request. This time I must inject the controller I want to test with the dependency injection context. And indicate which service will be injected as a mock. If I want to inject a spy, I have the spy bin annotation. I will need this object mapper to map an object to a JSON content. And to link the controller with the MockMvc object, I have this builder. Now, to work with the Spring mocks, I must use this syntax. And perform the HTTP request to the controller.
This time, the validation, the assertions, can be made directly in the MockMvc output. I can validate it with the jsonPath method, with some kind of regex, or getting the response, parsing it into an object, and verifying the fields of the object as done until now. Before running the test, as I need the Spring context to be loaded, I need all the components of my Spring application to be configured as the database. For that, I will use an in-memory database, H2. I will exclude JUnit here to avoid conflicts with the version 5. And now configure the connection to this in-memory database. This test took a lot more time because it has to load all the Spring context. And now let's take a look about how to test Spring repositories against a database with some data. I've already configured an in-memory database, H2. I did it because I don't want to ensure an external database is created and the connection is correctly installed. I want the database to be created on the fly at each test session. I've added some XML files ready with some content to be injected in the database. The transactional annotation works in the reverse way for the test than for the production code. When present, the data won't be persisted when the test ends. And I will add some listeners to indicate when the database must be cleaned and the dependency injection used. This annotation will inject a dataset in the in-memory database before running this single test. I may put this annotation at a class level if I want this dataset to be injected for each test. And now, before running the test, I must ensure that Liquibase knows about the in-memory database. I will add an inclusion in the POM XML. And now, let's run the test. The rest of the test remains as before. I only added a single test for each case, but in the Git repository, I've added plenty of tests, trying to reach the 100% coverage with tests.
As said, the tests must be written while writing the code of the application, not at the end. The tests are the best way to verify an application. They are the quickest way to verify its behavior. Never forget the tests. I hope you enjoyed the second part of the video about testing a Spring Boot application. If so, click on the like button and subscribe to my channel to see more videos. See you soon, bye!